This morning, whatever time you are watching from, is a great God. It's a great God. It's our first battle at midnight this year, but we're going to have it every last Friday of the month. Every last Friday of the month. So you don't have to be reminded about it. Every last Friday of the month, we are coming here to battle and receive our victories. So that we can usher ourselves to the new month. Last month, we entered a new month in church. Amen. Today again, we are entering a new month in church. Amen. In the next couple of minutes, we are going to be in the new month. Hallelujah. Amen. It's not a question, God knows about it. This is double upon double. Amen. So we are changing our months. Amen. We are changing our months. Hallelujah. Amen. I thank God for the prayer that preceded me, but we are going to pray again today. We're going to start with mercy and proceed. And proceed and proceed and proceed. God is going to visit you today. This hour that you are spending with God will not be in vain.
Amen.
Many of you, when you get back home, 1 hour sleep will be more than enough. Amen. For the night. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The Bible says the entrance of the world bringeth light and understanding to the same. Lord, your word is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path. Let the word that we shall hear and speak not be an enticing word of a man. But let it be the word of God that will bring glory to thy holy name. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Let's go to the book of Psalm 102, verse 13. Because many of you, God is going to visit you with mercy.
Amen.
You see, mercy, the Bible says, if I find mercy in your sight, if I find mercy in your sight, that means his mercy is within you, it's around you. God will bypass some things. A man that carried mercy. Mercy brings grace. Mercy brings favor. We are going to discover it here today. Psalm 102, verse 13. He said, you will arise and have mercy on Bishop Ezobele. Put your name there. You will arise and have mercy on Bishop Ezobele for the time to favor her. Yes, the set time has come. So mercy will bring favor. If you're asking for favor and you don't have mercy, favor will not come. So will God have mercy for you, or have mercy on you, or on your business, or your family, favor will show up. And when favor shows up, it brings grace. Favor brings increase. So everything we tell you, we are going to go systematically today. God is going to begin to open your eye. But look at how the Bible says, you will what? Arise. So when God wants to have mercy, he does not sit down and do it. He stands up to bring mercy. Because the Bible says there is a mercy seat that stays with God, where the cherubim and the seraphim, they guide the mercy seat because it carries the integrity of God. God is the God of integrity. And God guides his integrity very well. That's why the cherubim, when he gave Moses the pattern to build the ark, they were covering the mercy seat. And that's where God operates from. Mercy supersedes judgment. Today the Lord shall have mercy upon our lives. Amen. Have mercy upon our families. Have mercy upon this church. Have mercy upon your business. Whatever that needs mercy in you, mercy will come.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
Because when mercy show up, favor will come. Masatarama.
Amen.
I want us to pray this prayer. It's 12 midnight. I want you to stand and say, Father, arise and have mercy upon me. Arise and have mercy upon me. Arise. My Father, arise and have mercy upon me. For the time to favor me has come. The time to favor the church. The time to favor my business. The time to favor my ministry. The time to favor my family. The time to favor my studies. The time to favor my career. The time to favor. Masa Katarama. Arise and have mercy. Oh Lord, arise. Oh Lord, arise. Have mercy upon me. Have mercy upon my business. Have mercy upon my family. Have mercy upon my community. Have mercy upon this ministry. Have mercy upon our vicinity. Proximity. Have mercy. Let mercy begin to speak for us tonight. Masa Katayama. Speak, O Lord. Speak, speak, and speak, and speak. Masa Koto Yokonomo. God have mercy. Le karabasatara baba baba. Le progoshatara baba baba. Le karabasitoro baba. La karababa. Le karabasotoro baba. Le karabasatara baba. In the name of Jesus Christ, have mercy, O Lord. Have mercy. Have mercy. Have mercy. Have mercy. For the time to favor us has come. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Psalm 68. Hallelujah. God is still going to stand tonight. If God is standing for you, every man will stand for you.
Amen.
If the Bible says, let God arise. If God can stand for you, no man will sit against you. No man will be against you. If God stands for you, men shall stand for you. Psalm 68, are we there? Look at verse 1. What did he say? We are going to pray there again. Hallelujah. What did he say? He said, let God arise. Let his enemies be scattered. Let those also who hate him flee before him. Father, arise against my life. When God is arising, not for God, God is arising for you. Amen. Lord, you shall arise today. Arise, let my enemies be scattered. Let my enemies be scattered. Let my enemies be scattered. Lord, arise by the authority and the power. Lord, arise and let my enemies be scattered. Holy Spirit, arise. Jesus Christ, arise. By the authority and the power, in the name of Jesus. Lord, arise. And you are not rising. You begin to rise. Everything about you begin to rise. It is the Lord. It is not man. It is the Lord who raised Moses. It is the Lord who raised Bishop Ezobel. It is the Lord who raised you. It is the Lord who brought you here. It is the Lord. It is the Lord. It's not man. It is the Lord. It is the Lord. Father, advance us. Raise us out of ashes and dust. Raise us in penury. Raise us out of nothing. Raise us in Atlanta. Raise us in America. Raise us as a whole.
as a unicorn in this city. Raise us, O Lord, Father. Lord, raise me. Tell God to raise you. It is the Lord. It is not man. It is no woman. It is not anybody. Lord, raise me. Raise me. Advance me. Carry me. Masikete yababa. Masokuto yobo. Lebanga shatara mababa. Masikata sakana mababa. Makaraba shotorobo. Holy Spirit, raise me. Raise me today by the authority and the power in the name of Jesus. Ikene masikana mababa. Masakata sokobo. Yekene masakata mababa. Masikoto sokono mababa. Bikaraba shatara mababa. Mebraga sintara mababa. Mekaraba shokorobo sokono robo. Lord, rest me. Rest me. Rest me. Rest me. Rest me. Advance me in this land. Advance me in the world. Advance me in Europe. Advance me in Africa. Advance me in Asia. Advance me in Australia. Advance me in New Zealand. Advance me in South America. Advance me in the Middle East. Lord, advance me in India. Advance me in Nigeria. Raise us in Atlanta. Raise us in New York, California, Florida. Raise us in Maryland. By the authority and the power in North Dakota, but in South Dakota, in New Mexico, in Nevada. Raise us up. In Virginia. Raise us in Pennsylvania. Raise us in New Jersey. Lord, it is the Lord that raised us. You can raise us everywhere. Raise men. Lord, begin to raise your sons and your daughters. Raise them from every slumber, every death, everywhere they are entangled. Begin to raise us. Raise this church. Raise our account. Raise our life. Raise our career. Raise us. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. When you begin to rise, there are some things, dimensions of power that begin to fight you. Jeremiah 51. But I told us last time that anybody with momentum can never be stopped. It's when you don't have momentum, little problems will stop you. If you take a train, if you go downtown by Piedmont Road and joining SR13, you see where the trains are lying there like snakes? They're packing there. If you take a little stone and put in one of the rail, as big as the locomotive of the engine is, and the combination of the power of the compressor and all the tons of power that that train have, if you crank that train and it's vibrating, and they select the accelerator, the train cannot move just because of a little stone. And engineers will be working day and night looking from one tire, in one wheel to the next wheel. They'll be searching to see if anything is holding it. And end of the day, they can see just little metal stuck in the rail, and that train cannot move. But if a train is already doing 60 or 70 miles, if you put the whole of this building in the rail, the train will go by it and still be going. If you put a city in that train, the train will go by it and still be going. Because it has what? Momentum. It has force. It's moving. When God has raised you, God will advance you. When God is advancing you, some of the challenges that you are seeing today, they will die naturally. People will be cursing you and you'll be prospering. People will be leaving you and people are coming. Business will, everything will be happening concurrently. That is both good and bad, but the good will outweigh the bad.
Amen.
Because you have momentum.
Yes, Lord.
You shall be advanced this year.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Jeremiah 51. Verse 20. Hallelujah. Oh, karabasa, karababa. The weapon that you are will start to manifest for God this year. Look at verse 20. Are we there?
Yes.
You say what? God said, look at the Lord of hosts is his name.
Yes.
He said, and Israel is the tribe of his inheritance. The Lord of hosts is his name. Look at verse 20. He said, you are what? So the battle that we are waging, we are the one that we fight that battle. Amen. God said we are his battle axe.
Amen.
We are his battle axe. Oh, come on. Okay, let me just read a little bit to excite you a little bit before we pray. Say, you are my battle axe and the weapon of war. For with you, I will break nations in pieces. God is not going to manufacture another weapon. We will say, let nation break, and they will break. Because we are weapons.
Amen.
Everything that proceeds from you comes. When you say, fire, fire come.
Amen.
Look at the next thing he said there. With you, I will destroy what? Kingdoms. 21. With you, I will break in pieces the horse and the rider. With you, I will break in pieces the chariot and the rider. With you also, I will break in pieces man and woman. So whoever is a man or woman, I can break them because God has made me what? His battle axe. The weapon that we fight with is the word of God. When you release, things will be happening. Talking about nations, do you know what it is to take out a nation? God said you can do it. You can.
Amen.
If you read and on and on and on. So, I want you to say to yourself, I'm a battle axe. In the hand of God.
I'm a battle axe.
In the hand of God.
I'm
a battle axe. We are in a battle tonight. Don't mercy for the devil. Mercy cannot come near them. We carry mercy, but they will not have mercy. They will be punished by the authority and the power. For everyone that has said that you will not rise, let them never see any good thing in life.
Yeah.
In the name of Jesus, the Bible says, suffer no witch to live. Whoever has declared themselves a witch or wizard against your life, they shall not live.
Amen.
They will not see tomorrow.
Amen.
Because you are battle axe. Everything the Bible said in Isaiah 7:7, it said, it shall not stand, neither shall it come to pass. Whatsoever the enemy, I want you to begin to pray. As a battle axe, begin to take your battle to anywhere that you want it to go. Because with you, God shall destroy nations. With you, God shall destroy kingdoms. Every kingdom against my life, against my family, against our church, against the ministry, against our members. Lord, we are battle axe. We begin to tear you down. Every altar, every covenant, wherever you are coming from, by the authority and the power in the name of Jesus, I am a battle axe. I destroy nations. I destroy kingdoms. Not by my power, nor by my might, but by the Spirit of God. Masaka Tajakara, Rebaga Sotoromo, Nebraga Shikanazaba, Masiko Tosokolomo, Mekende Rebashatakara, Masika Tasakanama. We come against thrones and dominions, invocation, incantation, every enchantment against our life, against our ministry, by fire, by force, we destroy it. Every power against our ministry, every power against our members, every power against our partners, every power of force against this church, against our branches, against our pastors, against my life. Lord, today we begin to send fire and brimstone from any altar where they have risen against us. We stand upon this altar that is built upon the blood. Let the blood that speaks better things than the blood of Abel begin to speak. In the name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' mighty name,
we bring them down in the name of Jesus.
Job chapter 18, verse 15. The devil is in trouble.
Amen. Yes.
Nothing will be left undone this year.
Amen.
When we finish what we are going to do for every month, at the end of the month, we wait for them. We wait for them. The last Friday, we begin to take it by force.
Amen.
We enter another month, we finish, we wait for them at the end of the month. We can't miss till the end of this year. Every last Friday,
amen,
is battle at midnight.
Hey.
Battle at midnight.
Hey.
O kama na sakara baba. Lebraga shiko tosobo. Mazika tasaba. Job chapter 18. Are we there?
Yes.
The devil is in trouble.
Yeah.
The devil, anyone that has troubled you, trouble shall trouble them.
Hey.
I said this year, trouble will trouble the ones that are troubling you.
Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus, the Lord shall trouble your troubles.
Amen.
I said the Lord shall trouble your troubles.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. Are we in Job chapter 18?
Yeah.
Look at verse 15. Someone should read for us, please.
They dwell in his tent.
Mm-hmm.
Who are not of his. Brimstone is scattered on his habitation.
Mm-hmm.
His roots are dried. Are dried out below.
Mm-hmm.
And his branch withers above. Above. The memory
of him. Perishes from the earth. And he has no name among what?
The streets.
The land.
Yes. He is driven from light into what?
Darkness.
And chased out of the world.
That's right.
He has neither son nor posterity among his people, nor any remaining of his dwelling. God will drive away the wicked. Let's finish it to 21. He said 21. Those in the west are astonished at his days. And those in the east are frightened. Surely, such are the dwelling of what? The wicked. And this is the place of him who does not know
God.
The wicked is in trouble.
Hey.
They will be wiped out. And this Bible says there shall be no posterity.
Mm.
Their sons will not live. Their daughters will not live. Mm. Nobody will remember them. Yeah. Their names shall be wiped out. You will see them today. Tomorrow they are gone. And their names is gone. And you say, what happened to these people? What happened to that person? God said, they shall be not remembered anymore.
Yeah.
That is what God is going to do. Every wicked man in your life. Today we are going to stand against the wicked. You know, I told you have to have them around you because they help you to pray. Wicked people are good because they help us. If you don't have wicked people, many of us will fall apart. We'll be out of God, church. We will be out with the devil. So wicked man remind us of who our father is. That's why we want them. To still be around. Not around us, but to be around. Because their activities keep us guided. But there is no room for the wicked. The Bible says that you will look for the wicked one day, and they shall be not. Everything is gone. That is what the Bible says here. Everything about them, their name is wiped out. Haven't you seen people that used to own streets? When you go, they will change the street and put somebody's name. And the memory of them is gone. Nobody remembers them with all their power, influence, and wickedness. Today, every wicked man, I want you to pray that prayer. The light of the wicked shall go out. That's what some translations say. You see, the light of the wicked goeth out. Today, every wicked man, their light begin to go out. Let their light begin to go out. Their light is their power. Their light is their satellite. Their light is what they used to see you. Their light, every wicked man or woman, every wicked, now wicked man, now wicked woman, your light shall go out by the authority and the power in the name of Jesus. Pray. You wicked, now wicked woman, now wicked man, your light shall go out. Your light shall go out. Your light shall go out. Your name shall not remember. Masakatana, my brogo sokoro, lebraga shakarama, masikotomo, mikarama satarama, makarama, makoro shikarama, lebraga satarama, makoro, your light going out, their light going out, by the authority and the power, masokotomo, lekarama, 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 makraga sokoro, lebrogo shikarama, mikasatatama, every wicked man, every wicked woman, every wicked people, wicked nation, wicked massacre. The wicked is in trouble. Today, every wicked man around me, every wicked woman around me, today let your life begin to go out. Let your strength begin to go out. Let your authority begin to go out. Let your power begin to go out. Today, you shall not remember anymore by the authority and the power in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, in Jesus' name we pray. Oh, Caraba, we are getting there. Matthew 21, 44. I think we'll read from 42, but I want us to get it. Matthew 21. This is Jesus Christ. Oh, I don't know who has rejected you. You will become the chief cornerstone in your family. Oh, something that has never happened to anybody that you know in your family will begin to happen for you.
Amen.
Positively. Matthew 21. Are we there? Yes, Lord.
Amen.
Oh, Karabasatarababa. Look at verse 40. Let's start from verse 40. Let's start from 41. He said, then said to him, he will destroy those wicked men miserably and lease his vineyard to other wine dressers who will render to him the fruit of their seasons. Verse 42. Jesus said to them, have you never read in the scriptures, the stone which the builders reject has become the chief cornerstone? This was the Lord's doing, and what? It is marvelous in our sight. So I don't know who is rejecting you now. They are going to come back to beg job from you.
Amen.
They are going to come back to ask you to come to their Christian or whatever they are doing. Because you have become a voice. 43. Therefore I say to you, the kingdom of God will be taken from you and given to the nations bearing fruit of it, not you. But 44, this is where we are going. And whosoever falls on this stone will be broken. And whoever it falls on, it will grind him to powder. The stone is Jesus Christ. People are playing with you. Sometimes people don't know that when you are a son or a daughter of God, they are touching fire. He said, whoever falls into that stone, Jesus is that stone. He said, the stone that the builders rejected is the chief cornerstone. Whoever falls on top of the stone shall be broken. And whoever the stone falls upon shall be grinded. Any man that shall fall upon you shall be broken.
Amen.
And anyone you remember, they are grinded.
Yeah.
Begin to pray that prayer. It doesn't matter who they are. When they fall upon you in any form or way, they try to go against you, they shall be destroyed. But when you remember them, if you remember them, what they shall be grinded, they become powder. They become powder. Because in you is Jesus Christ. Bible says, let no man trouble you. Galatians chapter 6, 17. Let no woman trouble you. For you bear upon you the mark of Jesus Christ. You bear upon you the body of Jesus Christ. You carry Jesus all over your body. Anyone that shall fall upon you shall be broken. And whoever you fall upon shall be grinded by the authority and the power. In this year, any man that will meet evil against you, they are gone. Masakataba. Anyone that is planning evil against me, your life is destroyed. Your life is already destroyed. Hey, if I remember you, if I even remember you, if I remember you, you will be gone. In the name of Jesus. Masokoto yobo. Mekete takaba. Sikataba niko robo. Mabrika shakanana. Mekere basoto robo. Makatatatatatatata. Lekere basoto robo. Nibraga shakanana. Lekorobo soto robo. Makatatatatatata. In the name of Jesus Christ.
I call upon you, Lord God Almighty, Father. And you, Father.
We are still praying, but I want to show you the benefit of mercy. Let's go back to that Psalm 103. Probably read 1 to 5, but you can read all of them. Read up to 1 to 17 when you get home, but we're just going to read a few verses there. I want you to see something. Break every chain. 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 The chains are broken tonight.
Jesus.
There is power in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. We break every chain. Break every chain. chain. Break every chain. Chains have been broken now. Break every chain. Break every chain. Break every chain. Psalm 103 verse 1. It says, bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is written within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not what? His benefit. There are benefits in God, but this benefit comes from mercy. And forget not what? His presence is. Who forgives all what? One of the benefits that you receive when mercy is in your life is your sins are forgiven. Until we read about the wicked, God said, I can't forgive their sins. Their sins will not be forgiven. You know what it means for Jesus to say your sin is forgiven? That means you don't have judgment anymore. Mm. Mercy supersedes judgment.
Yeah.
Mercy, when you carry mercy, your job is just to acknowledge God. Your sins are forgiven. The prodigal son, with all what he did, he squandered half of his father's wealth. He came back and said, oh, you are my son. You were dead, but now you are alive. You were lost, and you are found. Sins was forgiven in the moment. Number one benefit is what? My sins are forgiven. Ah, caraba. Oh, no, look at number two. Let's go further. Another benefit. Who heals all what? Your diseases. Sickness will be far from your house.
Amen.
If disease is coming and see your house, say, ah, this is the wrong address. I'm not going there. Because there's a healing power already. Who heals all? Not some. No disease will last in your place.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. You say, who redeems your life from what? Destruction. You are indestructible.
Amen.
No man can destroy you.
Hallelujah.
Because mercy is inside of you.
Yes, Lord.
There is mercy. The Bible says, if I find mercy in your side, if I find mercy in your side, I will hear your prayer. If I find mercy in your side, I will forgive you. If I find mercy in your side, I will bless you. Mercy.
Hallelujah.
Who crowns you with what? Loving kindness and tender mercies. Verse 5. Who satisfy your months with good things. This month you are entering into good.
Amen.
You are not going to look for good. Because Amen. Mercy carry good. He said, he satisfy your months. Your months. Every month is a month of goodness.
Amen.
Every day is a day of blessing.
Yes.
Every day is a day of the Lord for you to expand. Hallelujah. Every day is a day of the Lord for you to excel. Amen. To explore. Great things are beginning to follow you in every area
Amen.
Of your life.
Amen.
Do we still have another benefit? Look at number 5. Who satisfy your mouth with good things so that your youth is what? Renewed like the eagle. So you are old and young, you become ancient and modern.
Amen.
You will be young until the day you leave. And people say, what is wrong? You'll be like what we call Igbo chicken in Nigeria, cook Igbo. They don't get old. Yes. When you see them, they always smart. I don't care how old they are.
Local chicken.
They are very agile. You cannot, sick bed is not for you. You will not end up in the hospital.
So
when the old age is coming, it comes with complication. You will age with grace.
Amen.
Hallelujah. That's what it is. He said, it renews you. Like an eagle.
Hey.
You will become young every day.
Amen.
Every day you are young.
Amen.
Every day you are young. Today you receive it. That's the benefit. But I want to show you something.
In the name of Jesus.
We are going to pray some dangerous prayer now.
Hey.
We are going to pray some dangerous prayer. People can die.
Yes.
Did you know that when you see, when mercy is around you, I don't care what has been done before, mercy show up. God will forgive.
Amen.
Let's go to 2 Kings. Chapter 3. Second King's story. This is a king that God have told the children of Israel, and God gave them a direct instruction. Say, the king of Moabite, say, go kill him and kill everything. And now Israel is proceeding. We don't have the story. And something happened.
I want to get straight to the battle side. I want you to see the what God said before we go to what happened. When they played the song to the king, prophet, in verse 16, and he said, "Thus says the Lord, make this valley full of dishes. For thus says the Lord, you shall see, not see wind, nor shall you see rain, but the valley shall be filled with water." So that your cattle and the, I want to see what he told them to do to the people when they get there, and also them.
Nineteen, yes.
He said, "Also you shall attack every fortified city and every choice city, and shall cut down every and stop up every spring of water, and ruin every good piece of land with stone." That means nothing should come out of that land. And when Israel proceeded, and they began to kill, but the king of Moabite, who was a demon, not a servant of God, he offended the children of God. When he saw that they were losing soldiers, they were losing the battle, and he said, "What does their God take?" And they told him, "His sacrifice." This is a king that is not supposed to be alive. Bible says he took his first son, the heir of the throne, and put him on the wall and killed him. And the Bible says, God said, "Please, don't touch him anymore. If an unbeliever can do this, let's have him one way." The mob king was a demon. He has terrorized Israel for years. And this opportunity, God said, "Go wipe out everybody." I want us to see 27. Verse 27. Start from 26. He said, "When the king of Moab saw that the battle was too fierce for him, he took his 700 men who drew sword to break through to the king of Edom. But they could not." Verse 27. "Then he took his eldest son who could have reigned in his place." That means there is no king anymore. He took the next king, the next generation, and gave him a sacrifice. This man was not a child of God, but he found out that why is it that we can't bring these people? We have more soldiers than them. We have more armories. We are more trained. We have everything, but we can't bring because God has spoken through Elijah, the prophet. Now, the man couldn't do anything. He took his son and put him on the wall and killed him. The Bible said, God said, no. I didn't ask for sacrifice. He put one. Don't touch him again. I want us to finish it. Today, you will understand that there are some battles where you are battling it. Look at 27. "Then he took his eldest son, who could have reigned in his place, and offered him as a burnt offering on the wall. And there was a great indignation against Israel. So they departed from him and returned to their own land." The moment he killed his son, God said, "Come back. What are we going to do again?" The man has killed the next generation. He has forfeited that rule already. For him to put his son in the wall, this is what God will still do in the future. That this man, an unbeliever, is putting his son, the only son, the heir of the throne, put him in the wall and killed him. And blood was gushing, and the whole soldier saw it. And the children of Israel retreated. Bible says, and the Lord has indignation. You know what is indignation? There was a spirit of indignation against Israel. It's like Israel now were the ones that sinned against God because somebody put sacrifice. When you have mercy, it goes with sacrifice. When the man put sacrifice on the wall, and God said, no, come back. Leave him alone. Don't touch him again. We're going to pray. I don't know where they have God to make sacrifice against your life. Mm. That things are working the way it's working. There's a blood that is higher than that blood.
Amen. Right.
I don't care whether they kill 100 people against your family. There is a blood that is purer than the blood that they use. Yes. The blood that speaketh better things than the blood of Abel is already crying.
That blood is speaking. I want us to tap into the mystery of the blood of Jesus Christ and begin to invoke the mystery. Let that blood begin to speak, because God also walks with blood. Let the blood of Jesus begin to speak for you. Let the blood speak. Let that blood that is shed upon the cross of Calvary, let that blood begin to speak. Men have gone to different places, to different altars, to raise every kind of indignation against your life, against your family. Lord, I plead the blood. I invoke the mystery in the blood. We release the blood upon this house. We release the blood upon your sons and your daughters by your authority and the power. In the name of Jesus, let the blood of Jesus begin to speak for them better things than the blood of Abel. By the authority, let the blood begin to speak. Begin to plead the blood upon all over you. You shall not die young. You shall not go in battle. You will come back to defend what God has given to you. You will come back with testimony. You shall come with caravans of blessing this year. You shall live long. Every sickness of the Egyptians shall be far from you. Be far from your family. Be far from what you do. In the name of Jesus, because the blood is speaking upon your life. The blood. God will not spare his son. Because God wanted to get the whole earth. He put his son on the cross and took his life. Let the blood begin to speak for you now. Let the blood begin to speak for you now. Let the blood begin to speak for you now. Let the blood begin to speak for you now. By the authority and the power. Mazakata Jaba. Mebranda Shikorobo. Mikatasakanama. Makorobo Sotorobo.
Oh,
in the name of Jesus Christ. Isaiah chapter 10. Oh, come on, Mama. Something great. Yes, Lord. Lion of Judah, reign. Jesus, reign. Isaiah chapter 10, 27. King of Zion, Lion of Judah, reign. Jesus reign in my life, King of Zion, Lion of Judah, reign. Jesus reign. Isaiah chapter 10, look at 27. It shall come to pass today. It shall come to pass, not tomorrow, but today.
In Jesus' name.
That the burden of the devil, his burden will be taken off your shoulder.
Amen.
And his yoke shall be taken off your neck.
Amen.
Yeah.
And the yoke will be destroyed.
Yes, Lord.
Because of the anointing.
Hallelujah.
Every burden of the enemy. Many of you are walking with your shoulders down. Today you start to walk straight.
Amen.
His bundle shall be lifted up your shoulder.
Hallelujah.
The yoke off your neck. I'm not just taking out the yoke, but the yoke shall be destroyed. That means the yoke is not coming back.
Yes.
Every yoke that the devil have yoked you with, some kind of places, yoked you with demonic altars, yoked you with familiar altars, yoked you with ancestral spirits, yoked you with marine power. Yoku makata sakanama mazekoto yobo. Every yoke, it shall be destroyed. It shall be destroyed. The Bible says the yoke shall be destroyed. There is an anointing of all over your life. Many of you are carrying your head is anointed with oil already. We had an anointing service here on Sunday. It was great. The Bible said, thou anointed my head with oil and my cup shall overflow. Today, every yoke of the enemy upon this ministry, it shall be destroyed. of Jesus Christ. Masakataya Baba. His burden, the burden of the enemy, shall be lifted off your shoulder. No more shall you carry things that are useless. Carry generational curses. No more shall you begin to carry ancestral spirit and powers. The yoke shall be destroyed. Every burden of your family that is wearing you down. Familiar spirit. Every burden of sin, it shall be destroyed. It shall be destroyed tonight by the authority and the power. In the name of Jesus Christ, the yoke shall be destroyed also. Every yoke shall be broken. Every yoke shall be destroyed by fire, by force. By fire, by force. Libanga shikara ba sotoro, makara ba satara ba ba ba, mekere ba satara ba ba. In the name of Jesus Christ.
In the name of Jesus.
Oh yes, Lord. Jesus reigns. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Masi kete yaba sakara baba ba. Oh, just begin to thank Him. God is doing something now. Masakata yaba. Masi koto tobo. Yaba kashikuru bumbu. Lepraga satara baba ba. Masi kata sakana masukuru bumbu. Yebaga shikara basikana mama, maziko doso kono bobo, libraga shatara baba baba, masakata baba baba, libraga shukuru bobo. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus Christ, le karabaso kono sokono sekele mama, libraga shatara basatara baba baba. Masoko to sokono sekele baba baba, libraga shikara basoko no bobo. Makarabasotorobobo, lepraga shakata sabara, likarabasatarababa, mazekete yaba, lepraga shotorobobo, mazekata sakanama, mazokoto sokorobobo, lepraga shatarabababa. We give you all the glory. We worship you. Masakata sekerebaba. In the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, Karababa, just give Him all the glory.
My God, the glory.
Masatana Baba.
Cannot be taken away from me, Father Lord God Almighty. In the name of Jesus, O Lord God Almighty. As we are in your presence, O Lord God Almighty, we know you are doing and continue to do exceedingly and abundantly, Father Lord God Almighty. Also, your favor.
Let's go to the book of Hosea chapter 2. I want us to pray this prayer because your blessings are coming this month. Hosea chapter 2, 21. And we in Hosea. Look at verse 21. Isaiah, not Isaiah, Hosea chapter 2. Hosea chapter 2, look at verse 21. I want us to use this to conclude our prayer. Pray it together. God said, it shall come to pass today.
Amen.
It shall come to pass. The Bible said that day, but that day is now. It shall come to pass today that I will answer. That means your prayers are answered, says the Lord. Who said it? The Lord. He said, I will answer the heaven. And they shall also answer the earth.
Amen.
And the earth shall answer with grain, with new wine, and with oil.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And they shall answer who? Bishop Ezobele. How Karababa. God said, I will answer heaven. So when you pray, your prayer will go to the heavens. God said, I will answer heaven. Heaven will answer earth. Earth will answer your business. When you say you are grace, you are called, you are one. These are where you do your business. And that your business will answer you. Today, let God begin to answer heaven.
Amen.
Over my life. Let your heaven, that's why the Bible says, when your heaven is open, your head shall bring forth. When the way of a man pleases the Lord, he shall make even his enemies to be at peace with him. The Bible says, that kind of masikorobobo, if my people that are called by my name shall humble themselves and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, I will hear from heaven and I will answer them and I will heal their land. So everything that you are looking for is in your land, is in your job, is your business. God said, I will answer the heavens. And the heavens shall answer what? The earth. And the earth will answer my business. The earth will answer my church. The earth will answer our members. The earth will answer your boss. The earth will answer to something. And that thing will answer you. It will answer you. It shall answer you. Receive your answer today. Receive your answer today. Receive your answer today. For God has answered you. The Lord has answered you. The Lord has answered you. The Lord has answered you. Masakatata Baba. Masokoto Yomomo. Nebraga Shatara Baba. Makira Basanaba. Lokoromomo. Yekara Baba. Masikatata Baba. Makara Baba. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Look at 23. I want us to finish it. So when the earth answers, when your business answers you, he said, then I will sow her myself. Because we are his what? Right. I'm sure I myself in the earth. And I will have what? Mercy on her who had not obtained mercy. If you have never obtained mercy, mercy is coming.
Amen.
God said, I will have mercy on her.
Amen.
I will have mercy on him. I will have mercy on those. He said, then I will say to those who were not my people, you are my people.
Yes.
And they shall say, you are my God. So God said, he has answered us. But there will be something like a reconciliation. There should be a party. If you have never had a happy, some people say, nobody gives me anything. I earn everything. Because mercy is far from them. Mercy is coming your way.
Amen.
Things you didn't know, you would just be passing by and they say, please come and share from the blessing. Because you carry mercy. God have heard your heavens, and your heavens shall hear your earth.
Amen.
And your earth will hear your job.
Amen.
Your earth will hear your business.
Amen.
Your earth will hear your prayer.
Amen.
And your prayer will hear you.
Amen.
Today your answers are coming.
Amen.
In all these chains of how the thing will go,
amen,
no one will misfire.
Amen.
No one will stop.
Amen.
The blessing will go from those stages to the stages to get to you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ,
amen,
you shall celebrate this month.
Amen.
This is the month of love.
Amen.
We are sharing love this month.
Amen.
Love will never be far from you.
Amen.
Even people that didn't love you begin to love you by force.
Amen.
By the fire and authority in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Put your hands together for Jesus. Just thank you for what he's done.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.